It's Mikey, and today we're going to focus on farming and Destiny. Basically, a cheap and dirty way to rank up, make money, find rare items, or Ingrams. So we're going to focus on two of the most popular ways, the Moon Mission, the Dark Beyond. I already made a video just for that. Easy way to make 5-6K every 30 minutes. But lately, really popular is the Skywatch farming. Now, you don't make as much money, but the thing about it is you get lots of Cryptarch prep and the chance at a legendary item. Your odds are way higher. There's way more drops. Not as much money, but way more drops. So let's talk about the downsides, though. So since I haven't talked about Skywatch, just some real quick and easy tips. Before you go there, can you please do the community a favor and go there by using the patrol method? Some people click directly on Skywatch, and there's people out there that actually want to complete that mission. So if you're going in there just to farm, you're really making it tougher on everybody. You'll get the same results if you go via patrol, okay? The open world type thing. So go ahead and do that. And so in case you don't know where Skywatch is, it's past, you know, where all the planes are and stuff. You go through that little path, just ignore all the enemies. And the thing is, when you pop out, you're probably already going to see people shooting at the spot. So you can just go ahead and join them. It's really easy to catch on if you haven't done it. And as most people know by now, you can see where this guy is on the left. That's perfect. You don't really want to go past that point. Just hang back and preferably use like a pulse rifle. The other thing I want to say is sometimes you'll see other clusters of aliens. People will ignore them. I found that if you kill them, get rid of them all, usually that'll force more enemies to spawn out of the cave. And then another little thing, don't ignore the light, the orbs of light, your friends or the people near you're gonna drop by, because that'll just let you use your super much faster. The other thing is, you don't need to rush in there constantly. Your ammo for your primary, that's gonna regenerate every 30, 60 seconds. So if it's you and three friends, you don't need to run in there. You really don't. You can just wait it out 30 seconds while your friends are just going at it, and then your ammo's gonna replenish magically, and then you can go at it too. Like, I realize, you know, when you're playing with random people, you can't control that. And yeah, if they go in there, then yeah, you might as well go in there with them. The other big thing a lot of people don't know is everyone can get loot on any enemy, death, and range. And it really doesn't matter if you killed him or even damaged him. If you're there, if you're present and you see it, if it's in your range, the game's gonna give you credit for it. And you know, just to touch on running in there all the time, the blues and purples, you know, the stuff that matters, it will be sent to the post office if you disconnect, if you leave, it's gonna be sent to you. So again, you do not need to be rushing there all the time. Yes, I know other people will do it, but I'm just saying, if it's like you and two of your friends, you guys could just hang back. And it's beautiful when you get like four or five people who don't rush in there. Oh man, it's magic. There's just so much loot dropping. I will say though, see the downside of farming on Skywatch, it's so random. Sometimes you get people that'll block the cave, they'll start dancing, trolling you, you know, they'll prevent the spawn, so then you gotta leave and then come back. Another thing, there's random events. Sometimes this big ass war will happen, so random, then they're actually pretty tough. There's a public event that happens. That's actually not a bad thing. That's really a great way to get some Vanguard rep and marks. But that is the thing. It's random and unpredictable, whereas farming on the Dark Beyond, on the moon, totally predictable. You know what's going to happen. But again, you are not going to get as many Ingrams and rare items and Cryptarch rank on the moon like you will right here on Skywatch. So there you go. Both methods are great. The moon, again, an easy 6K, I would say, every 30 minutes. Pretty good. Really great for completing challenges. I have a link below to that video. Skywatch, really great. A chance at some good stuff. I did get a legendary weapon. You will go up a few Cryptarch ranks, so that's good. Just the downside, you gotta deal with random people. Who knows what's gonna happen with them. And I will say, I do think that these methods will be patched or something's gonna happen pretty soon. So definitely enjoy them while you can. If you want to play with me, do open lobbies, things like that, Twitter, Facebook, links down below. Please take 3 seconds, rate the video, and I see you next time. And this time, I'm going to show you how to max out your Vanguard marks. Vanguard marks are what you use to buy equipment, weapons, whatnot, and you're only limited to making 100 a week, but I'm going to show you how you can hit that in just a couple hours. So we're going to do that by playing public events. Here is something very, very important, and I will have this also down in the description. The public events work by the clock. They go by the time. So you need to figure out when you're starting to play the game. For this example, we will be starting at the top of the hour. And just for this example, I'm going to be using